Greetings. Thank you, Sister Sabile, for an interesting dialogue. You have said something which I think needs to be answered in video. No Muslim is a Muslim if he didn't believe Jesus Christ, anointed, appointed. But Christians say he was incarnate God, God in shape of human. We believe his miraculous birth. We believe he healed blind and lepers by birth. We believe he was Christ. We believe he was the mightiest messenger of God. But we don't believe he was God. He never claimed divinity. I understand the many claims Islam teaches you to assert, sister. Unfortunately, they are empty words when compared to the truth. Let's look at the answer I posted in message form. What does believe Jesus Christ mean to you, Sister Sabile? Only a fool would deny Jesus existed. So simply believing he existed is nothing to brag about or be proud of. Only believing that God came in the flesh is a remarkable belief, Sabile. Prophet Isaiah said a voice would announce God in the earth. Isaiah 40 verse 3, a voice is calling, clear the way for the Lord, Yahweh, in the wilderness. Make smooth in the desert a highway for our God. Do you believe Prophet Isaiah, Sister Sabile? Do you believe what Prophet Isaiah said, Sister Sabile? Do you believe the God of Abraham would come to earth as Prophet Isaiah said? If you do not, Sister Sabile, you do not believe the prophets. Prophet John said he was the voice who would announce God in the earth, Sabile. Matthew 3:3, this is he who was spoken of through the prophet Isaiah, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. John 1:23, John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, I am the voice of one calling in the wilderness, make straight the way for the Lord. Do you believe Prophet John, Sister Sabile? Prophet John said he was the voice to announce God in the earth, Sister. Do you believe what Prophet John said, Sister Sabile? If you do not, Sister, you do not believe the prophets. If Islam makes you reject what Prophet John said, Islam is not from God, Sister. Do you believe the one John announced was God in the earth? This is the message of Prophet Isaiah and Prophet John, Sister. Prophet Malachi said that God himself would come to his temple as a messenger. Malachi 3:1, behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. That passage speaks of John the Baptist. And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, whom you delight in, behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. Do you understand the verse I just read, sister? God will come to his temple in Jerusalem as a messenger for his own covenant. Do you believe Prophet Malachi, Sabile? If you do not, sister, you do not believe the prophets. If Islam does not allow you to know what the prophets said, sister, it is evil. Do you believe God came to his temple? I would say clearly you do not, sister, because your religion denies the message of the prophets. All while Islam commands you to say we believe the prophets, but denies their actual message. Jesus was God come in the flesh to the earth as the prophets foretold. John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Verse 14, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we saw his glory, glory as of the only begotten from the Father, full of grace and truth. If you do not believe that Jesus is God, you do not believe the prophets or Jesus, Sister Sabile. God sent the prophets, sister, to reveal himself to mankind. His prophets were faithful and true in their message, and damn the false religion that denies their message. Prophet Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth," which in Arabic is Al-Haq, one of Allah's 99 names, "and the life." Do you believe what Jesus said, sister? Jesus made claims about who he was. If you don't believe it, you don't believe Jesus. The claim Muslims believe Jesus is just false, sister. If you do not believe Jesus was crucified, died on the cross, and rose from the dead, your belief is empty of any meaningful details of the reality Jesus accomplished. The Word of God says in Romans 10:9, "If you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved." You have to believe first that Jesus died before you can believe God raised him from the dead. This is the very reason Islam exists, sister, to deny the crucifixion and resurrection. Christians do not exceed their religion, as Muhammad tried to claim in his Quran. God's plan exceeded Satan's awareness and ability to stop it. Believe Jesus was Yahweh, as the prophets said, and do not say, "We believe God is alone," and think that is their only message. Let me finish with one other truth from the Word of God, because God has directly addressed your claim. James 2:19, "You say you have faith, for you believe that there is one God." Good for you! Even the demons believe this, and they tremble in terror. The Muslim claim is no different, no better than what even demons say and believe, sister. You must believe that Jesus is God come to earth, the Word made into flesh, sister. This is the message of the prophets, sister. 1 John 4:2, "By this you know the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God." This gets back to an earlier comment in this video, sister. There really is nothing special about believing a man named Jesus existed. The remarkable belief is that Jesus was God come in the flesh, as the prophets foretold. Anyone who confesses this is of God. Any religion, any self-proclaimed prophet who denies this is not of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Word of God made flesh and come into the earth. Amen.